Hey, welcome back to the Complete Guide to Horror Movies channel. So for this video, I'm going to be ranking all the different Saw entries that include Spiral and Jigsaw. So let's count down the top nine in celebration of the release of Saw X, which is still a few months away, but hopefully a trailer drops soon. Number nine, Saw 3D, also known as The Final Chapter. I don't necessarily hate this movie. I just think that there were so many production issues. It's well documented that the director was actually had his like contract like clause or some bullshit like that. He had to jump from Paranormal Activity to direct Saw 3D, The Final Chapter. And you can tell that they just tried to sandwich two movies into one. A lot of decisions don't make sense. And also, why the fuck did Joyce have such a terrible death? It's like the worst death in the whole franchise. And she was innocent. So I will always be pissed off about that. But also, the movie's just kind of, I don't know, shithouse a little bit. Like, I don't really enjoy it when I rewatch it. And for that, it's lucky number nine or unlucky number nine. Same thing.
The last piece of the puzzle is you.
Number eight, Spiral. This could have easily been, I guess, like the refresh of the franchise. We had Chris Rock jump on board as a starring role, also a co-writer. But where Spiral falls short is that there's just not enough Jigsaw. I mean, sure, we get some of the traps, which are creative at best, but it's just not a Saw movie. It wasn't something that I was. I mean, they do try and tie it back into previous installments lazily with like the headshots on the board in one scene of like Xavier from Saw 2. And yeah, we do see pictures of Jigsaw, but I don't know. It was kind of a shit story. And no offense to the screenwriters and no offense to the cast and crew behind this movie, but it had, I guess, the right ingredients, but just didn't really do anything. This is actually the most boring Saw movie for me. So I was tossing up between swapping that or Saw the Final Chapter for last place.
It's gonna go sideways fast.
Number seven, Jigsaw. I am a very big defender of this Jigsaw movie. There was a 7-year gap, as we all know, between Saw the Final Chapter and Jigsaw. What I really liked about this movie, funnily enough, is the writing. I really like the story where it's also a prequel, but it's also a sequel, but it's also happening in real time. And for me, that's where the cleverness really adds to this mix of the Saw franchise, which is known for its twists and turns and convoluted, I guess, storyline, which happened over the course of the movies. But where it falls short for me is that this does seem kind of boring as well. Yes, there are traps and yeah, there are some things, but I don't know. It just, again, like it feels like a Saw movie, but then there's so many stupid parts to this. Like, I mean, the ending where the guy gets his head sliced open like a flower. Okay. Like, I don't know. There were so many stupid things like that. Also, how the hell would they know which needle, if they stuck it into Carly's neck, would actually let them go? That has never made any sense to me, how the logistics behind some of these traps work. I don't know, it felt like they were more copying like the House of Jigsaw or the IMDb forum boards for inspiration for these traps. Still like everything else, but it is what it is.
No, it's not creepy at all.
Number six, Saw 3. There are quite a number of fans for Saw 3. I am not one of them. I remember seeing this when I was 14 years old in the cinema. Yeah, the gore factor was cool, but it definitely felt like they were just trying to overdo this so much to the point where there was no next level or stepping stone for them to go because they already did everything. I mean, the rat trap, that is one of the most horrifying things I've ever seen in all horror movies. So where do you go from there? You can't really go anywhere. So it feels like they shot themselves in the foot. I know that it was reported that this was supposed to be the concluding chapter of a trilogy and that they didn't expect a fourth movie would get made. But I mean, come on, this is a franchise. It was making millions of dollars at the box office. So surely they should have prepped something for Saw 4. And yet, it just seemed they were just like, ooh, traps here, traps there, traps everywhere. But kind of dialed back on the storyline. So yeah, not exactly my favorite. I don't hate it, but I don't think I've rewatched this one since it actually came out, Soz.
Oh God.
Number five, Saw 5. Saw 5, I will defend this film a little bit. I did think it was interesting the first time I watched it. I particularly liked the maze sequence with the five, what do you call them? The five five or some bullshit like that. Like, I liked how the whole thing with that trap was they all had to work together and they all went against their instincts or something like that. So I thought that was cool. I like the Strom versus Hoffman storyline. But again, I don't know. On repeated viewings, this is so fucking boring. I'm sorry. Even with all the traps and all the different characters, I mean, there are some people who are cast against time, like the Stanley Tucci lookalike versus the girl who gets electrocuted in the bathtub. But it's just not really that interesting to rewatch. So, yeah, so that's why it's number 5.
Better luck next time, rich boy.
Survival of the fittest, my ass!
Number 4, Saw 4. And so this is the only Saw movie I've never watched at the cinema. And I don't know, I kind of wish that I did, because this was a very interesting movie. Yes, it focuses on Rick, one of the lesser known cops, I guess, from the original trilogy. And I like that his whole gameplay was structured around, don't do anything. If he doesn't do anything, he actually saves the lives of those he's trying to save. I like that message behind it. What I didn't really care for was the fact that out of nowhere, we have another accomplice in Hoffman. I mean, fuck me dead. I say that now, and yet there's like 600 accomplices by the time we get to Spiral. And I don't know, I just feel like there's something missing from this one as well. Opening sequence, horrifying, so that's good in my books. Storyline, yeah, it's all right, following Rick around and all that. I was a big fan of that. But then, again, it seems like with these traps, they're trying to outdo the gore factor of the previous movie. But as I already talked about with Saw 3 already upping the ante, they were just like, well, we haven't had scalps ripped off and we haven't had huge circular blades and all this bullshit. That's like, well, what could have happened? But also, I was low-key hoping that we'd actually see Detective Samuel. What's his name? Detective, fuck, the guy from Saw 2, the dad, the cop, whatever his name is. I was actually hoping he would be in Saw 3, but we don't see him until Saw 4. So it was kind of just like, oh, he's there again. And he has a long-ass beard to signify so much time has gone past. Woo! Only for him to get killed with two ice blocks. Cool.
I still have fucking time!
What is your mental?
You fucking did this!
Oh, you idiot!
You fucking did this!
No, Jigsaw's testing you! You fucking piece of shit!
Number 3, Saw 6. I love this movie. To me, this is the absolute top 3 Saw movies of all time. I love the storyline. I love the traps, even if some of the traps are really fucking dumb and easily escapable, like the maze room one. All she had to do was just tilt her head back, and then the whole spear just would have gone flying, like, next to it. I know it's all movie and all that stuff, but I mean, come on. It's like Jigsaw kidnaps all these people from, like, I don't know, like a Lady Gaga concert or some shit. Just gets the dumbest people, so never understood. However, the storyline at play, I think, is incredible. I love that it goes against the health industry, the insurance industry. I love that it still follows the clear motive of cherish your life, which was introduced in Saw 1. And again, love the twist ending. I love that, you know, when they say upping the ante in terms of gore value and whatnot, felt like it kind of held back in this movie all the way until the very end with the whole acid needles. That was so fucking cool. And also, I really love Pamela Jenkins. She is my number one girl crush. Pamela, I know you're a fictional character, but I will marry you. Anyway, moving on.
No, Brad!
You killed my father, you motherfucker! Oh. Now you burn in hell.
Number 2, Saw. Grab your pitchforks, I didn't play Saw as the number one movie. Why? Saw is boring. I'm sorry, it really is boring. It is a single movie shot in one room with occasional glimpses into other sets like the razor wire maze and the flammable jelly, whatever you want to call it. And look, those sequences are really good. For me, this falls short with the main storyline. We're just waiting to see what actually happens. Yes, there's some good energy throughout this movie, and let's not forget that twist ending, which is still the king of twists in every single movie. I've never seen anything like this recreated, not even with Gone Girl, not even with other so-called mystery thrillers, if you like. For me, this is the king, but at the same time, I do like one movie particularly better.
You don't know me, but I know you.
Number 1, Saw 2. For me, this is the perfect Saw movie. House full of people trying to get their way out through an escape? Check. Crazy demented bitch who turns out to be a secret accomplice, but is only used sparingly? Check. Jigsaw's still somehow in the movie? Check. additional storyline with a broken cop with his son who also happens to be the victim in one of their house. Check. This is an incredible movie. I love Saw 2. I rewatch it every year. I think it is the ultimate best Saw film. Everything was taken to another level compared to Saw. We had more characters. We had another accomplice. We had more backstory into Amanda from the first Saw movie. I didn't think she'd be a character in the sequel. And yet it was just surprise after surprise. And also the traps were pretty fucking gnarly. So, you know, got to give it to the top spot. Let me know your thoughts on my ranking below in the comments. Also, make sure to post your ranking of all the Saw films. I love reading all these comments. Keep it respectful, but hey, I don't mind if you call me a piece of shit. We've recapped all the Saw films through our podcast, The Complete Guide to Horror Movies. There is a link in the description and should pop up at the end through that bubble or some bullshit. Remember to cherish your life, make smart choices, and keep an eye out for Saw X with hopefully the trailer dropping very, very soon. I've heard rumors that it might be mid-June. I was actually hoping for CinemaCon, but hey, beggars can't be choosers. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Game over.
Hey, squirrel friend. When one video ends, just open up another one. It's called binge viewing. Go ahead. I support you.